the Senate passing its version of a massive tax bill. That bill, though, is facing serious scrutiny this morning.
It is hundreds of pages long, and the fine print could have all sorts of impacts on American families. And ABC Stephanie Ramos is in Washington as well, taking a look at some of the more unusual provisions here. Stephanie, good morning to you.
Dan and Cecilia, good morning. This bill is hefty. Now, to get this Senate tax bill passed, it took a full day of Republican leaders making amendments to the bill so that certain members would get on board with the measure. And a majority of senators eventually did, and the president is taking credit for it. This morning, President Trump taking a victory lap of sorts after the Senate passed a sweeping tax bill.
It's the largest tax decrease in the history of our country by far. Not even close.
Democrats pouncing, some saying even reading the bill was a challenge.
I can read one word. It's called add this language. Can you tell me what that word is?
This is a massive tax bill with changes to the U.S. tax code that haven't been made in 30 years.
The Tax Cuts and Jobs Act, as amended, is passed.
Here's just a slice of what's in it. The elimination of the Obamacare mandate, slashing the corporate tax rate from 35 to 20%, doubling the standard deductions, but abolishing all individual state and local income tax deductions. For Americans making more than $100,000 a year, it could mean a big tax cut, but middle-class Americans making less than $75,000 a year could end up paying more in taxes over the next 10 years. But there are also some new and surprising amendments, like tax breaks for private jet owners and for alcohol producers. Now, the next challenge lies with the House. Both the House and Senate must work out the differences in their two bills. And the House votes Monday to begin the process of merging those two bills. Now, we don't know when the Senate will do the same, but the deadline for this bill to be on the president's desk is about 3 weeks away, just in time for Christmas. Dan, Cecilia.
Stephanie, thank you. For more on all the political news in the morning, let's bring in ABC News chief anchor George Stephanopoulos, who's going to be hosting this week later this morning. George, good morning to you. So do you think this bill ultimately, I know there are hurdles ahead, do you think it'll ultimately pass? And how big a win is it really, given how unpopular it is?
I think you have to bet yes right now, because both the House and the Senate, they've taken the toughest vote so far, and they've clearly made the political calculation that despite the unpopularity of a lot of what's in the bill, they need to pass something. That said, nothing is guaranteed in Washington these days. Remember, the deadline for the government shutdown, government runs out of money this Friday. That could complicate the tax negotiations as well, because of a lot of things that some senators have requested have to be in the bill. So you can't guarantee anything at this point. You also have that Roy Moore election coming up in Alabama on December 12th. If he loses, will that impact these negotiations? Have to wait and see.
White House still thinks they can get this done by Christmas, mm-hmm. though they really need this one. We also saw from the president this weekend that tweet where he said for the first time that he fired Flynn for lying to the FBI. Why is that significant, and given everything going on this week?
Well, because what would have if he had known that Flynn had lied to the FBI at that time and then asked, according to James Comey, to let that investigation go, that is a prima facie case of obstruction of justice, which I think is why the White House is now scrambling to say, no, the president didn't write it. His lawyer wrote it, although it was still the president's words, and the president hasn't taken it back on that tweet at all. But it would be quite significant if President Trump were to admit that, and if that were true when he fired, when he asked Comey to let go of Flynn, and when he fired James Comey.
And they're in a tough situation here, because the White House has always said those tweets speak for the president, mm-hmm. so that's a tough one for them.
So we speaking of the president, we heard him repeating his mantra on Saturday, no collusion. He also said he's not nervous after Flynn agreed to cooperate with the special counsel. Is he right not to be nervous?
That's a good question. It depends on what General Flynn has said to the special counsel. You have to assume, if you look at how narrow the plea agreement was and how light a sentence General Flynn could get, 0 to 6 months, that he's given up an awful lot to Special Counsel Robert Mueller in return, that he would incriminate others on the president's team, perhaps even the president himself. But we don't know exactly what Flynn knows. We don't know exactly what he's told Mueller, but based on past experience, you have to assume it's a lot.
Always great to see you on a Sunday morning, George. Thank you very much. And a reminder, as always, George has a big show coming up. He's going to be speaking with the Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell about that massive tax cut bill.
And plus, he'll go one-on-one with the top Democrat on the House Intelligence Committee, Congressman Adam Schiff, on Michael Flynn's guilty plea in that Russia investigation. That is all coming up soon on This Week.